Okay, so you don't get paid. Discard.
You will be understanding about the formation of various rocks. So firstly, I'll be showing you video of sedimentary rocks. Okay, so if you have understood after this, then you just type in the chat box you understood the formation of sedimentary rocks nicely. Till then, I would like to admit some more students. Otherwise, after
कॉपीराइट पड़ जाएगा फ्लू कार्ट का.
Now, so can you see this screen, all of you? Now, in this screen, on the top of the picture, there is a picture of magma. And this magma is coming out through the volcanic eruption. And as I told you, when I was teaching you about formation of igneous rocks, that time only I had told you that igneous rocks are formed by after cooling of the magma. Magma is cooling and solidification takes place, and afterwards, this magma is converting into igneous rocks, which is also known as primary rocks. Okay, so can you see first in first figure it is shown of magma, and afterwards it is converting, it is from magma is cooling down and solidification of the magma is taking place, crystallization of the magma is taking place, and it is converting into igneous rocks. Okay, so igneous rocks, you know about the characteristics of igneous rocks. It is one of the hardest rocks. Okay, examples also you might be knowing. And afterwards, what is happening? When weathering is taking place, when due to this weathering, transportation and deposition, this igneous rocks is converting into sedimentary rocks. Okay, sedimentary rocks. So it is converting completely into sediments. Okay, now it is converting into sediments, not sedimentary rocks. Into it is igneous rocks are converting into sediments. How it is converting into sediments? When the weathering is taking place, transportation is there, then deposition is there. These are the type of cuttings of the rock by the various agents. These agents can be wind also. These agents can be the flow of the rivers also, the flow of the water also, the heavy rainfall also, glacier also, isn't it? So various agents are there for the cutting of the rocks. So this weathering, erosion, transportation takes place. Okay, now igneous rocks, when weathering, erosions, transportations or deposition takes place, this igneous rocks convert into sediment. Sediment, you know, small, it is like a sand only. Okay, all the rocks are being eroded, or it's converting into sand only, or gravels of stones. Okay, and slowly these sediments are, it is not a single process of 10 to 15 years or 10 years or 15 years. No, it is a process of 10 million years or 10,000 years. Slowly these sediments, which is deposited by the river or by the glaciers or by the sea waves, are responsible for the formation of sedimentary rocks. As I told you about the formation of sedimentary rocks in that video only. Did you see that video? How the sediments are forming? It is squeezed. Okay? It is squeezed. That means cementation is taking place. When sediments are deposited on the bank of the river, what is happening? Eating. Sedimentation, cementation is taking place. And due to that cementation, due to that squeeze, that rock, the formation of sedimentary rocks is there. Okay? And after this sedimentary rocks, all of you see the figure, you can understand it nicely. Now, after this figure, after the cementation and the compaction, that is also known as lithification, what is happening? Sedimentary rock is forming after the cementation, after this compaction. Okay, after the formation of sedimentary rocks are getting heat and pressure. Okay, when sedimentary rocks are getting more heat and pressure, then after getting more heat and pressure, these sedimentary rocks are converting into metamorphic rock. Can you see the last rock is metamorphic rock, students? Did you see this? Just see the screen if
Yes,
you are
sir.
not. Yes. So lastly, why it is forming? When this sedimentary rock is getting excess of heat and pressure, then it is converting, it is changing into metamorphic rocks, okay? And after once again, metamorphic rock is melting and converting into magma. Like this way, this rock cycles goes on, okay? So this diagram may come in exams, and you have to give explanation also of this diagram, so practice it also. Diagram will also come, map work will also come, okay? So you have to practice a lot. So shall I go with the economic significance of rocks, or anyone is having any doubts, then speak up about your doubts, so that I will go with the economic significance of rocks. Anyone have not understood anything, just tell me that. I'm giving you 2 minutes to ask. Afterwards, I shall explain the lesson.
Screen presenting.
Yes, Peter.
Stop screen presenting or continue.
Yes. No, stop. Thank you. Stop presenting. Now, so anyone, shall I begin with economic significance of rocks?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And if anyone is having any doubts regarding any topic, you just keep the doubts. Lastly, we'll be just solving or discussing about all the doubts, whatever you are having. Okay. Now, economic significance of rocks. Now, what are the economic significance of rocks? Firstly, formation of soil. Secondly, storehouse of minerals. Third is building materials. Okay. Building materials. So, formation of soil. How rock is playing an important role for the formation of soil. Now it is written clearly that rocks provide parent material for the soils. Soil is a complex mixture of minerals and organic matter and support growth of all types of plants. Bulk of soil comprises of the minerals that are derived through weathering of rocks. We all know, children, due to whatever erosions, depositions, these are the form of cutting of rocks. Erosion is type of cutting of rocks. And how this cutting of rocks takes place? By the various agents. What are these various agents? Wind, okay, storm, rainfall, water flow, okay, current of the water. So these are the agents through which this erosions on depositions are taking place. Okay. Now, formation of soil. So now try to understand that rocks are only providing the materials for soil. Now, soil, how it is forming?
Rainfall,
now, rocks are also flow, due to the erosion, it is becoming a. You all know that the soil is a complex mixture of minerals and organic matter.
Erosions on
that
depositions
means
are
rocks are only. Due to erosion, okay. Due to deposition, it is converting into soil after some times, okay? So weathering is a process of disintegration and chemical transformation of rock material. Thus, all agriculture production on the surface of the earth depends indirectly upon the rocks. So weathering, I told you that due to various agents, rocks are being converted into soil. Erosion is also the same, only weathering is also the same. So one lesson is also there about this erosion and weathering, how these rocks are converted into soil. Now, so later on, these rocks are converting into soil, and it is responsible for the formation of soil. And we all know that soil is very important for agriculture purpose. Next is storehouse of minerals. How soil is important for, or how rocks are storehouse of the minerals. Why we can say this? Okay. Now, rocks contain a variety of minerals. As I have told you in the previous lesson also, this lesson also, that almost all rocks contains minerals. Okay, so some rocks have a large content of certain minerals. These minerals are obtained from such rocks, such as rocks having a large content of particular minerals called ore of a mineral. Okay, if now we obtain all minerals from different rocks, so it's not like that. Even each and every minerals we are getting from rocks only. Okay, how we are taking out or extracting the minerals? Now there are various processes of extracting the minerals from the rocks. Like if gold will found in the rock, then that will be melted, and then gold will be extracted from that. If diamonds are found in the rock, it is being experts are giving shape. If they are knowing how to cut the diamond from the rocks, then it is being polished, isn't it? Likewise, whatever minerals are being found in the rocks, they are being extracted in a particular process. Okay, so it depends on an archaeologist or the geologist who is studying about the minerals, who are studying about the things which are found under the earth. They are experts in identifying these rocks, that which rocks are containing which minerals. By seeing the rocks only, they can easily identify this archaeologist, this geologist. Okay, they are only studying this only. They are specialized in this study. So sedimentary rocks are especially rich in organic material like coal and petroleum. Most of the metallic minerals, like what are the metallic minerals? Iron, copper, bauxite, lead, zinc, gold, are obtained from the igneous or metamorphic. So these are the metallic minerals. So metallic minerals, and basically these iron, copper, bauxite, lead, zinc, and gold are obtained either from igneous rocks or from metamorphic rocks. So these are extracted. If agar kisi ko pata chala ki gold hai, agar is rock mein gold contain karta hai, to simply kya kiya jayega? Usko tod ke nikalte nahi hai, usko burn kar dete hain temperature pe. Okay, फिर वो बर्न होके वो पूरा लिक्विड फॉर्म हो जाता है, फिर उससे गोल्ड को एक्सट्रैक्ट करते हैं. अंडरस्टूड? डिड यू सी द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ गोल्ड और एक्सट्रैक्शन ऑफ गोल्ड स्टूडेंट्स? इफ आई गेट टाइम आई शो यू दैट हाउ मिनरल्स आर एक्सट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम द रॉक्स. ओके, सो दैट इट विल बी, लेट मी कंप्लीट द पोर्शन, देन ओनली आई विल बी शोइंग वीडियोज ओनली, सो दैट ऑल द कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ योर विल बी नाइसली क्लियर्ड. Okay, students. Now, precious stones like diamonds, rubies, emeralds are also obtained from igneous and metamorphic rocks. Excuse me. Now, many of the minerals are used as industrial raw materials to make products like cements, glass, chemical fertilizers, limestones, clay, and gypsums are examples of such rocks. So, now, building materials. Building materials, a number of rocks are used as building materials. You know, children, that various types of rocks are used for building materials also, for the construction of houses also, roads also, dams also. So it depends. Like marbles, granite, you might have seen marbles in most of your houses, marbles and granite might have used, isn't it, students? Everyone have seen marble and granite?
Yes, ma'am.
And please switch on your radio. Okay, please switch on your video and please give response also. Okay, now marbles and granite are examples of such high priced building materials. So you might have seen, everyone might have seen marbles and granite, because in most of your houses, marble and granites are used. So I don't have to tell you much about that. Now, they are not durable, but also provide an attractive finish to the buildings. So marble and granite are not durable, not very strong. It's very delicate also. But when we are using this marble and granite, our house becomes more attractive. It's expensive also. But we are using, why we are using it? Because it seems very attractive, and it is being used in our house. It is making our house more attractive. So we are using marble and granite. Now next is The poor people obtain building materials from these for their houses from the common rocks such as sandstone, quartzite, and limestone. And the rock thus fulfill a number of human needs. So many of the people are using in many of the ancient monuments also, this sandstone is being used. Okay, like Red Fort, red sandstone is used in Red Fort. Okay. So in many of the monuments also, many are constructed with this sandstone only. Okay. Now, so is that anyone is having doubts, please clear your doubts. And students, from this week only, your remedial classes will be starting. And weaker students of geography, I have given the names also to your class teacher. And this is for remedial classes are started for the students, those who are weak. Okay. So if anyone, I already have given the name. Now, anyone is having doubts? Okay, Vedanti, you want geography class?
Yes, ma'am, I have messaged you also.
Okay. I didn't try it in ninth. Okay. Ninth A, na? You are in ninth A or ninth C, Vedanti?
Ninth A.
Ninth A, yes. I'll be writing your name, Vedanti. And any more students? I'll be giving the names of ninth A also. So any doubts in regarding any of the topic, please let me know about the doubt. Then I shall go with the question answers. Anyone, please? Anyone is having any doubts? No one is having? Please tell me about your doubts. Because if you have not understood anything, please tell me about that. I shall make you understand that thing clearly. Or if any topic, if you have not understood, I'm talking to each and everyone. And CR of 9th A. Now, you have to take care of your class. And I think CR of 9th A, 9th A, whatever CR are in the class, you have to take care of this class. Whenever classes, your duty is to look after this class. Everyone should respond to the teacher when teacher is calling. This is a very important thing. Otherwise, next class, I'll be just putting that name in the MCB. I'll be just disclosing that name in the MCB. These students are not responding when teacher is calling. So you have to take care of that, students. We are not telling you to search any answers and get. We are only telling you and asking your doubts. That's all. And that then also if students are not responding, then simply we will be putting your name in the MCB. That following students of 9th A or whatever class are not responding in the class. So just take care of that. Now, yes, anyone is having, yes, Ashleen, you are asking something, Bita?
No, ma'am.
Anyone is having, shall we go with the question answers of this lesson?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, one by one, please get ready for giving answers. What is a rock? Now, who will say what is a rock?
Ma'am, page number 59.
So everyone, just mark it in page number 59. Yesterday, I had given this question answers in 9th B, I think so. All of you, please do open page number 59. Rocks.
Ma'am, first paragraph. Any mass of hardened portion of the earth's crust can be called a rock.
Yes. Everyone, did you get the answer? Please mark it. Did you get the answer, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So many minerals, so many exam definitions are given in that page, I think so. So whatever you, okay. Now next is name three, 1 minute. I will call the name and they will give only the answer. Name three types of rocks. Yes, Kranti.
Name page number 59.
Please, Bita, when you're giving answer, switch on your video. Please. Yes, Kranti.
Ma'am, page number 59, last three lines.
You can't tell three types of rocks. Don't tell me. Give the answer.
Igneous rock, sedimentary rock, and metamorphic rock.
Okay. Now, yes. Next question. Yes, Vedanti. What is magma?
Yes, ma'am. Answer is on 60 page. Due to high temperature in the interior of the earth, the rocks are in the molten state. The molten material is called magma.
Okay. You can write this definition from glossary also. Okay. In glossary also, the definition of magma is given. So you can write the definition from the glossary also. Okay, students?
But ma'am, in the 60 page, it is little detailed one.
So, yes, but definition will be of 1 or 2 marks. So, you can exaggerate your answer. No problem. Okay, students, whatever way you want to write, you can write the definition. Okay? Did you mark? Everyone marked? Please do it. Now, next. Yes, Rachit. Switch on your video, Rachit, first. What are primary rocks? Rachit, switch on your video. Let's write the name. So students are not responding. Huh? I'll put the name in there. Rachit? Rachit? Rachit Srivastav. Rachit. Yes, Sarthak. Sarthak. Now, what are primary rocks? Who will tell this?
Yes, ma'am.
Students are leaving the class when answers. Yes, Arthur, what are primary rocks? Can you tell me? If you're not knowing the answer, that also you tell me. I will tell you the answer.
Ma'am, I don't know. Because I...
Okay, who will tell this answer? What are primary rocks?
Ma'am, may I?
Yes, start.
Page number 60, igneous rocks are formed through deposition and solidification of volcanic material. Igneous rocks are of thermal origin. Since they were the first rocks to be formed, so igneous rocks are also known as primary rocks.
Okay. Did you mark, students? Page number 60, please mark. Did you get the answer, page number 16, students? All of you, since they were... Since igneous rocks are the first rocks to be formed, or since they were the first rock to be formed, so igneous rocks are also called primary rocks. Everyone got the answer?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
What are sedimentary rocks? Who will tell this answer? It's written in the glossary only. You mark from the glossary, students. Okay. Now, what are the major classification of rocks? What is
ma'am, it is secondary rocks.
Ma'am, it is secondary rocks.
Sorry. What are secondary rocks? Who will tell you? Who will tell this answer? What are secondary
rocks? Ma'am,
yes, dear.
Ma'am, page number 62.
Page number 62. All of you, please mark. Page number 62.
They are formed through the process of sedimentation. The rocks formed in this manner are called sedimentary rocks. They are also called secondary or derived rocks, as the material is derived from other rocks.
Okay. Okay, the rocks formed in this manner, okay, are called sedimentary rocks. They are called secondary rocks or derived rocks as the materials derived from the other rock. So you can write from here, all of you pay, open page number 62. They are also called secondary or derived rocks as the materials derived from the other rock. So it is known as secondary rocks. Okay, did you get it, everyone?
No, ma'am. On which page number?
Page number 62, you just see.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, time is up, and now in the next class we'll be discussing. Till then, everyone go with the answers, mark the answers, and I'll just tell the answers in the class. Okay? Bye, all of you. And if any doubts or queries are there, if anyone wants to, already I've given.
You want me to?